We have finished the gradient of the line, the equation of the line. We agree that the gradient of the line M equals rise over run or y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. This is the gradient of the line or the slope of the line. And the equation of the straight line y equals mx plus c. M stands for slope of the line or the gradient of the line or the steepness of the line. C, the y-intercept. Okay? Now, how to draw the line if you have the equation of the line. For each equation, write down the gradient, write down the intercept on y-axis, sketch the graph without plotting points. So we'll do that for A, and then you can solve the rest by your own. Y equals 2x plus 1. What is the gradient for this equation? What is the gradient for this line?
Mx plus 2.
I need the gradient. Gradient equals 2. So for A, because the general equation y equals mx plus c, so the number in front of x, the coefficient of x is called the gradient or the slope. Okay? The gradient or the slope. And C, the y-intercept. So now, we apply the, for A, y equals 2x plus 1, so M, the gradient, equals 2. So, M equals 2. The gradient equals 2. The y-intercept, 1. So, y-intercept equals 1. Now, can you sketch the line without table, without plotting points? If you have the gradient and y-intercept, you can draw the line directly. We consider this x-axis. We have x-axis and y-axis. X and y. Zero, one, two, three, negative one, negative two, negative three, one, two, three, four, negative one, negative two. Now, how to sketch the graph of the line without table, without plotting points? First, y-intercept equal one. So already we have point. Y-intercept equal one, so this means this point. Am I right? This zero, one. So this is the point. This is the first point. So already we have one point. From the y-intercept, we have one point. Y-intercept equal 1, so 0 and 1 is the first point, belongs to the line. Now I need one more point to join them. The gradient equals 2. M equal 2. Can you write 2 as a fraction?
Yes.
How?
2 over 1.
Yes, 2 over 1. So write the, write the gradient as a fraction. So 2 can be written 2 over 1. We know that the gradient rise over run. So this means change of y over change of x. If the numerator positive, up, move up. If the numerator negative, move down. What about the denominator? To the right or to the left? If the denominator positive, move to the right. If the denominator negative, move to the left. Now, 2 over 1. This means 2 unit up and 1 unit to the right. 2 unit up and 1 unit to the right. Start from the y-intercept, start from this point. Then move 2 units up. 1, 2. Then 1 to the right. This 1 to the right. So this is the second point. Okay? 1, 2, then 1 to the right. Now this is the second point. Now join them. So this is our line. So first, start from y-intercept. Y-intercept equal 1, start from 1. gradient, write the gradient as a fraction. 2 can be written 2 over 1. The gradient rise over run. So, this is the change in y and change of x. If the numerator positive, move up. Negative, move down. So, the numerator up or down. According to positive or negative. The denominator to the right or to the left. According to its positive or negative. If positive, move to the right. Negative, move to the left. The numerator, if it's positive, move up. If it's negative, move down. Now, because 2 and 1, this means 2 to the 2 up and 1 to the right. So 2 up and 1 to the right. Okay? Have you finished A?
No.
Okay, finish and try to solve B by your own. For B, y equals 3x minus 4. Layan, the gradient equal what and y intercept equal what? 4b. 4b. Gradient? 3. Y-intercept?
4.
Negative 4. Negative 4. Take care for sign. Now draw x-axis and y-axis. Where is y-intercept? Negative 4, so negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. This is negative 4. So this, we start from y-intercept, Ranim, okay? This y-intercept, negative 4. Now, write the gradient as a fraction. 3 can be written as 3 over 1. So 3 unit up and 1 to the right. 3 unit up and 1 to the right. So 3 unit up, 1, 2, 3, then 1 to the right. So this is the second point. Now join them. This is how to draw using y-intercept and the gradient. Is it hard to draw?
No.
For C, the gradient equals 4, which can be written as 4 over 1. And the y-intercept equals 1. So you can draw now. Y-intercept equals 1. 4, this means 4 up. 1, 2, 3, so we need to extend the line. And 1 to the right. Then join them. Now for D, y equal 5x minus 3, so the gradient equal 5 or 5 over 1 and y-intercept equal negative 3. Now if you draw, negative 3, this negative 3, the gradient 5, so 5 over 1, so 5 to the right, 5 up and 1 to the right, and 1 to the right. So this is the second point. Now join them. For E, y equal x plus 1, x plus 2, so the gradient equals 1, and y intercept equals 2. Y-intercept equal 2, so this y-intercept. Gradient equal 1, so this can be written 1 over 1. So 1 up and 1 to the right. So this is the second point. Now join them. Now if you need a help for f, y equals 0.5 x plus 7, so the gradient equals 0.5 or 1 over 2. Y intercept?
7.
7. So now draw. So 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This y-intercept, 7. The gradient 1 over 2, this means 1 up and 2 to the right. 1 up and 2 to the right. 1 up and 2 to the right. Then join them. So this is the right. This number f. Number 4, a straight line passes through the points 0, 1, 3, 7. What are the coordinates of the point where his where this line cuts the y-axis?
0, 1.
Yes, because if x equals 0, this is the intersection with y-axis. So 0, 1 is the point where the line intersects y-axis. So the answer for a 0, 1. Okay, so if x equals 0, this means this is the intersection between the line and y-axis. Okay, if x equals 0, this means the point belongs to y-axis. B, by plotting both points on a coordinate grid, calculate the gradient of the line. Can you find the gradient of the line without plotting?
No. Yes.
We can. We have two points, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. If you have two points, you can find the gradient. Okay? But because he needs the plotting, so we need to plot the points. 3 and 7, 0 and 1. So. Zero and one, this is the first point, 0 and 1. 3 and 7, 3 and 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 3 and 7. Now we need to find the gradient of the line. To find the gradient of the line, you have two ways. You can find the gradient of the line y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So 7 minus 1 over 3 minus 0 equals 6 over 3 equals 2. So the gradient of the line 2. Or you can find rise over run. If you join them, okay, rise equals 6, run equals 3, so this 6 and 3. Now you can find the gradient, rise over run, so 6 over 3 equals 2. Okay, yes, because by plotting both points, so we need to plot the points. Okay, so you can find the gradient from rise over run, or y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Now the equation of the line, y equal mx plus c. So this means y equal 2x plus 1. Okay? Straight line, pass through the points 1, 2, 2, and 6. What are the coordinates of the point where the line cuts the y-axis?
There is no 0, 0, 0.
So we need to plot the points. And by plotting, we can extend the line and we can find the intersection with y-axis. For number 5, we need to plot the point 1 and 2, 2 and 6. 1 and 2, this is the first point. 2 and 6. Now join them and extend the line to find the intersection with y-axis. The line intersect y-axis at intersect y-axis at negative 2. So the line intersect y-axis at negative 2. So the y-intercept negative 2. The line you can use the rule y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. You have 2 points. So the gradient of the line, 6 minus 2 over 2 minus 1 equals 4 over 1 equals 4. So the gradient of the line equals 4. Or rise over run. Yes. So you can join this triangle. This 4 and this 1. So the gradient 4 over 1, which is 4. Okay? Rise over run. So the equation of the line now, y equal mx plus c, so y equal 4x minus 2. You don't need to write plus negative 2, so minus 2 direct. So 4x minus 2. 4x minus 2. To find, we have 2 points, okay? We have 2 points. Can we find the equation of the line without drawing? Without drawing, we can find M and C. We need to find the gradient of the line, the y-intercept of the line, then we can find the equation of the line without drawing, okay? Now, we have the points 1 and 2, 2 and 6. You can find the gradient directly, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. You get the same answer, which is 4. So m equal 4. So now you can find the gradient, but can you find the y-intercept without drawing?
Yes.
We can find the y-intercept without drawing. Now you have the gradient equal 4. Am I right?
Yes.
The gradient equal 4. So write the equation. So y equals 4x plus c. Now how to find c? To find c, we have 2 points. You can substitute by any one of them to find C. You can substitute by 1 and 2 or 2 and 6. You have a choice. You can take any one of them. By substitution, you can find C. Now, if we substitute by 1 and 2, okay? 1 and 2. So this means X equal 1, Y equal 2. So 2 equals 4 times 1 plus C. So 2 equals 4 plus C. To find C, transpose 4 to the other side by negative. So C equals 2 minus 4, which is negative 2. Okay? So we can find y-intercept without extend the line, without a graph. Okay? If we switch by the second point, 2 and 6, we get the same answer? We can check. Okay, y equals 4x plus C. Now we need to substitute by the point 2 and 6. This means x equals 2, y equals 6. Now put y equals 6, so 6 equals 4 times 2 plus c. So 6 equals 8 plus c. To find c, transpose 8 to the other side by negative. So c equals 6 minus 8, which is negative 2. So we get same answer. So we can find y-intercept by substitution by any point on the line.
Can you put y equals 2 and x equals 6?
Wow.
The point 2 and 6, so x equal to y equal 6.
Well, can
you change it? Not change. This ordered pair. Order does matter. This x, this y. Sorry? No, not the small. It's the first number for x. The second number for y. This is called ordered pair. So order does matter. You need 6f?
Yes.
Okay. You have 2 points. 1 and 1, 4 and 10. I need the equation of the line. So I need M and C. M and C. So to find M, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So 10 minus 1 over 4 minus 1. 9 over 3, which is 3. Okay? Understood how to find the gradient? Y minus y over x minus x. Lama, you can write. Look. x1, y1. x2, y2. Then apply the rule for the gradient. y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Listen. Now write the equation, the second step. Write the equation of the line. So y equals 3x plus c. How to find c? Substitute by any point. You can substitute by 1 and 1 or 4 and 10. You have a choice. So if we substitute by 1 and 1, so both y equal 1 and x equal 1. So 3 times 1 plus c. 3 times 1 equals 3. So 1 equals 3 plus c. Transpose 3 to the other side by negative. So c equals 1 minus 3, which is negative 2. So c equals negative 2. So the equation of the line, y equals 3x minus 2. That's it. Understood? E, we have 1 and 3, 2 and 7, okay? So same, to find the gradient, 7 minus 3 over 2 minus 1, so 4 over 1 equals 4. Now the gradient, the equation of the line, y equals 4x plus c. Substitute by any point, 1 and 3, for example, 1 and 3, this x and this y. So 3 equal 4 times 1 plus c. So 3 equal 4 plus c. Transpose 4 to the other side. So c equal 3 minus 4, which is negative 1. So the equation of the line, y equals 4x minus 1.